You two shouldn't fight anymore. Your mommies are so affected by it. That's how much they love you.
Just remember, when it comes to Isabella, I'm on your side, Kara. And if you need any help finding her, just ask and I would gladly help you with the search.
If I did you wrong or might have hurt you somehow in the past, I'm sorry.
It's all in the past now.
On Alex, I'm practicing for the audition. If Becca's going, then I should go too. But on, what if they choose Becca over me?
Well, I'll do everything I can to make sure they'll choose you, okay, Hannah?
Where's Gonzalez?
It seems he escaped, boss.
How unfortunate of you, Dina. I would love to be your ally, but you're too greedy to share your blessings.
From now on, you'll be the one collected from Dina's clients. I guess your friend lost her touch.
I saw Sarah earlier. She was with a child. It must be her daughter, because she looks exactly like her.
Hello?
Hello, Ma'am Laura. This is Edward speaking.
Edward?
Sarah, you mean to say Becca doesn't know a thing about Edward? If Edward is Becca's real father, then he has the right over the kid. Unless Becca's not his real daughter.
I don't think we should feel sorry for Becca. Because we're all here for her, to make up for our father's shortcomings. And even though she has no father, she shouldn't feel inferior or that anything's lacking.
You mean Edward?
Mama, is he my papa? Isabella will come back, Aunt Kara, because if you love Isabella very much, she'll know it in her heart that you're looking for her.
Sarah mustn't see this picture. I need to be careful. This isn't the right time for them to find out that Becca
is Isabella. This isn't about you and Edward. Whatever happened to the both of you, Becca's out of it. Why don't you introduce her to
him? I'm her only parent, not Edward.
I told myself before, if ever I'll have a child, dude, I'll never abandon him. So if it's true that Sarah and I had a child, I'll do everything I can to take responsibility.
I'll go ahead. Alex, please, make sure you don't take your eyes off the children.
All right, Kara, don't you worry. I'll take care of them.
Then, of course, I got the chance to get the chick's number. She even messaged me right away, you know? Then after that... Hey! You know what? I've been babbling here the whole time, Seb. But you weren't even listening to me? So what on earth are you looking at?
Nothing. Just pictures of Hannah and Becca. While waiting for the audition.
Well then, why do you look so sad?
I'm thinking about Sarah's daughter, Rebecca. I just remembered what we talked about the other day. She asked me about her father. You remember Edward?
Of course I do. He is Becca's father, right?
Mm.
So where is he now?
Well, that's exactly what she asked. And of course, I'm in no position to tell her I know something. We don't want Sarah to misinterpret or be offended by our concern for her only daughter. That's why we're letting Sarah explain the situation to Becca herself.
That's right. Well, you better not get yourself in trouble with Sarah.
What I don't understand is why would Edward do this to Sarah and Becca? I mean, how could a father do this to a child? When I lost my daughter before, I almost died, you know? You know what, Elvis? There's never a time that passes that I don't think about my daughter.
And then there's you, and then there's...
I'm so excited. Do I look okay?
Yes, you do.
Na 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 na. And then we'll shout.
Hello, Seb?
So Alex, how's everything there? Kara said she left the kids with you at the audition. Do I need to go there?
There's no need, Seb. I can handle these two. Besides, Kara said she'll be back right away.
All right. I hope you're not having a hard time there.
No, I'm fine.
I'm Alex.
Could I please talk to Hannah for a while?
All right, hold on a second. Hannah, come here. It's your dad.
Hannah?
Sweetheart.
I just want to say good luck.
Dad, I'm getting nervous.
You've been practicing, right? Besides, you really want this, right?
Shy, don't get scared. Okay. You can do it.
Just do your best.
Okay, Daddy. Thank you.
Just enjoy the audition with Becca, understand?
Think of it as if...
You're just playing, okay? So you won't get scared.
Okay?
I love you, sweetheart.
I love you too, Dad.
Good luck.
Why do you look so gloomy? Don't tell me you're nervous. We haven't started yet. You'll never get chosen if you act like that.
Mommy's not here, that's why.
Well, that's life. What do you want us to do? Her work is far more important than
you. I thought Mommy's going to be with me all the way, Aunt.
That's okay, Hannah. Well, look at Becca over there. It's totally okay with her that her mom's not here.
But Becca's better than me, that's why.
I'm getting ready because I'm going.
Then imitate her. You're not a loser. Besides, you'll go in first. I'm sure they'll choose you over Becca. Just go practice your routine. Come on, get busy, all right?
And then we will all dance. And we will have a good time. Come on, let's dance.
So what? Did you find Sarah?
Yes, boss, but we're having trouble getting in because there are lots of people in the club.
That's not my problem anymore. Just do what I told you to do, you hear me? There is no way I'm gonna stop until I make Sarah pay for what she did to me. She'll definitely regret what she has done to me. You know I easily fall for women, but I can be ruthless when I'm mad.
Becca, aren't you tired yet?
I'm all right.
Do you want juice?
That would be great.
All right, go ahead and buy some.
Huh? What happened to the ones we brought?
Hannah had finished it all. She got so thirsty because it's really hot. Is it okay if you buy it yourself? Well, you know how Hannah is. She doesn't want me to leave her side. You know, I could buy the juice myself for the two of you, but what if she looks for me, understand?
Huh? But what if they call my name at the audition?
Oh, no, I'll take care of it. I'll just tell them that you went out to buy something. Don't you worry, Becca. Take this. Here's the money.
Okay, I'll be quick on Alex. I'll be right back.
Okay, thank you so much.
Okay, Leah. Thank you. Next, please.
Who's next? Look, she's adorable.
Oh.
Okay, so Hannah, can you show us your talent?
Okay, sir. I think I shall never see a poem as lovely as a tree whose hungry mouth is pressed.
Was that it, Hannah?
I'm not yet done, sir. Can you hold a second?
I remember I passed by here. But why do all the doors here look the same? I think this is it. Are Aunt Alex and Hannah inside already? I guess not. Where are they?
I'm so sorry.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Mr. Hanson, but I was looking for something.
I should be the one to apologize to you. Are you going to the audition?
Yes, sir. Do you know where the audition is?
It's here. The audition is here.
There?
Well, where are your parents anyway?
My aunt and Hannah might be inside already.
Oh, all right. Let's see if they're inside. I think the auditionee isn't done yet. Can you wait for me here? I'm just going to take this call, okay?
Okay.
Hello? Can I help you?
Alms for the poor! Alms for the poor! Alms for the poor! Can you give me even a slice of bread? Have pity on a little girl like me who's thin and filthy and is very hungry, mister!
Oh no, that's my audition piece.
Good, Hannah. Do you have more to show us? Can you sing or dance?
Oh, yes, ma'am. I can dance. Ouch!
Oh. Hannah! Hannah, are you okay?
Rose, did the event turn out okay?
Oh, yes. Anyway, I'm so sorry. The client today was just demanding, you know. And Aunt Laura can't help us today because they also have an event.
It's okay. The client seemed happy with us in the end.
You saved the day. And good thing we convinced our other client to hold our event upstairs.
That's right. Anyway, I'm sorry. I really have to go. I need to get back to my
dad. Okay, go ahead.
I'm really glad you came over. The set became exactly as what we planned.
I hope your event will be a success, ma'am. Just call me if there are any problems.
But Kara, I hope you can stay for an hour or so. I just really want to make sure that everything goes well and is perfect. Especially during the opening of the VIP gates. Who knows what'll happen, and you know... Please, Kara. Oh, she's pretty.
Mm-hmm.
Hi.
Hello. She's pretty.
Yes, very pretty.
Good afternoon, judges! Good afternoon, Philippines! Good afternoon, world!
What's your name, baby girl?
I'm Rebecca Suarez. Becca for short. 7 years old from Quezon City.
She's so bubbly.
Yes, she's definitely bubbly.
Okay, Becca. Face the camera. Now face to your right. Good.
I'm so sorry. I got a call from a possible client.
It's okay.
Now face the camera
again. Look at
that
girl. She's the girl I was scouting for the last time.
Very good.
She would be perfect for the ad.
Good afternoon, Mr. Handsome. My name is Rebecca.
I'm Edward. Nice to meet you.
Okay, Becca. What will you show us today?
My declamation piece, sir.
Well, okay. You can start now.
Alms for the poor. Alms for
what,
the poor.
What, that again?
It's the same
it's the
thing.
Same thing.
It's the other girl did that already.
Else?
I know,
it's
right?
Too bad.
But she's really cute.
Banjo.
Oh, hey.
Go practice with them.
How did the audition go?
Well, I didn't get to accompany Becca to the auditions because your sister got me a job.
What? So Madam is all alone without any support, Sarah? Come on, let's go there.
No, it's okay. Kara's there anyway. And besides, I gave her some tips on how to ace the audition and a kiss for good luck. You know what? I have a strong feeling that our dream is starting to come true. I just know it, Banjo. Especially her going to a good school. Oh no, I'm really excited for that. Oh, before I forget, I need to call Kara. I want to know how my baby is doing.
Hey, Sarah!
Hi,
oh,
madam.
Wow, that was very quick.
Well, of course, definitely. I can do their faces even with my eyes closed, mother.
It's good you're already here. I think there will be a lot of people tonight. That's why we need to get everything going.
Oh,
Banjo,
right.
Please. You need to practice
Sarah,
your set well.
Here.
Look at the
okay,
table.
All right.
Go polish it some more. I have something
yes,
to check
madam.
Backstage.
You can do it, Becca.
Alms for the poor! Alms for the poor! Alms for the poor! Don't you dare come near me! You smell really awful! Besides, I might catch a disease from you. Can't you give me a slice of bread? Please, mister, have pity on me. A little girl who's thin and filthy and is very cold and hungry, mister! Where on earth are your parents? You should ask them for bread, because this bread is only for me!
I told you so, dude. She's the one.
That's very good, Becca.
Okay, let's continue, Becca. Now, let's pretend there's a flying wand in here in the room. And surprisingly, it changes your clothes and makes you into a princess. What would be your reaction? Look at her. She's really great.
Thank you,
oh,
Becca.
Very good.
Very impressive.
Thank you.
Good
Thanks,
job.
Everyone.
Good job.
I agree. I really
She's
like her.
Really awesome.
Thank you, Becca. You know what? You're really good.
Thank you so much, Sir Edward.
You're welcome. Come on. Let's go. Call the next one. Bye.
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 Bye. Goodbye.
Edward.
That girl's got charm.
Yes, I believe you now. She's really great.
Hannah, are you okay? They should have chosen me. But you embarrassed me, Becca.
But why, Hannah? What did I do to you?
I don't like you. Go away. I hate you.
But why are you mad at me? I didn't do anything to you, Hannah.
You humiliated me. You're bad.
But I swear I didn't do anything.
Because you were staring at me a while ago. I got confused.
I just took a peek, Hannah. Besides, I should be the one to get mad at you because you stole my piece.
Liar! You just wanted me to make a mistake so you can have an advantage.
That hurts. I didn't do anything to you.
Hannah, what happened? Are you okay? What's the matter? What on earth happened?
It's all Becca's fault.
Becca, why did you push her, huh?
I didn't mean to, Aunt Alex. She hurt
me. Don't lie
first.
To me, Becca. That's not what I saw. Hannah, look at you, my dear. I can't believe it. You're an evil witch. Shh, it's okay. That's enough. She's really bad.
Don't worry about her.
Okay, just stay here, Camille Rose, so the client won't have anything to say.
Sure, you're right, yeah.
All right. Hello?
Hello,
Mommy?
Kara? I'm sorry for disturbing you.
Mommy?
I'm having a slight problem here.
Can you come here right away?
Hold on, Alex. Is Hannah the one I hear crying? What happened?
Yes, that's Hannah. The two
Mommy?
Kids just got into a fight. I don't know what I'm going
Mommy?
To do now since Hannah wouldn't stop crying.
What? All right, don't worry. I'm heading back there now.
Okay, thank you, Kara.
Come back here.
Camille Rose, I'm sorry, but I need to go. The kids are fighting right now.
What? Oh, no. Okay, you should go. I bet they're already pulling each other's hair. By the time you get there, they're both bald already.
That's what I'm afraid of. Hold on.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Pose.
Okay,
Is
guys.
Is that okay?
Let's take a break.
Okay.
Thank you.
We'll get us some water.
At last, we're done.
Hello, Kara.
Hello, Sara. Can you go to the auditions now? I heard the two girls are fighting.
What? What happened?
Well, I don't know either.
What do you mean you don't know? You were with them the whole time.
I'll explain later, okay? Just go to the auditions now.
All right, I'll go there right away.
You take care.
What happened?
The two girls were fighting. My daughter needs me now.
What? I'll come with you.
Come on, let's go.
Your mom's coming here now, okay? She's coming, dear. Come on, that's enough. Come here, my dear. Stop crying. Oh, my poor Hannah.
Sir Dwayne, we need you to choose the kid for the commercial so we can inform the parents.
Yes, actually, of all the girls that auditioned, I've chosen three that I kind of feel would fit the part best.
Actually, sir, ma'am, I really like this kid. She's so cute and very bubbly.
Yes, I like her too.
Yeah, you know what? I like her too. She's the one we'll get.
Okay, sir. I'll be the one to contact her parents to sign the contract.
Okay. No, man, let me contact them. What's her mom's name?
Here.
Sara Suarez?
Hannah, don't cry anymore. It's all your fault.
Don't come near me. I don't like you.
Becca? Becca!
Hey, Becca, are
you
okay?
You little brat! What did you do to my daughter? Did you hurt her? Speak up! Why don't you answer my question?
Sara, what are you thinking? Let my daughter go!
Don't you dare hurt my daughter! She's the one who hurt my daughter first!
Sara, Becca scraped her elbow.
You see, Kara? My daughter got a scratch!
Even so, I'm the mother, Sara. I should be the one to discipline my child, not you.
You're right, Kara. You know what, Sara? You should scold your daughter first before anyone else, okay? Gosh, Kara, I can't believe it myself. I saw Hannah moving away to end it all, but Becca still followed her to fight with her. You keep your mouth shut or you're gonna get it from me! You know, I bet my daughter had nothing to do with this! And look at you! You're an adult, but you didn't do anything to stop the two from fighting! And Kara, what I don't understand is why you would leave the kids to that woman!
Come on, Sara. Don't you dare blame this on me. Why don't you ask yourself how you raised your kid? She really takes after you, because you're not only a witch, you're also a warrior.
What did you say?
Hey,
I
Sara,
really had
on
you!
Guys, would you just stop? That's
stare.
Enough!
She accused my daughter of being bad! You expect me to let it go?
Let's not make this a big deal, shall we? Can you tell us what happened here?
Mommy, Becca humiliated me during the auditions.
Humiliated?
Hannah got humiliated because Becca ruined Hannah's audition earlier. She got distracted, so she slipped and fell.
Becca, is this true?
It's not true. I just took a look at her
Becca,
audition.
Becca, it's bad to tell a lie, okay? And now you're accusing her of being a liar, huh?
Sara.
You're too much,
Sara.
Alex!
Come on, that's enough! If you truly believe in your daughter, then don't act like that.
What? She's accusing my daughter and I won't shut up. What do you want me to do?
Well, that's not what I meant, okay? All I'm saying is don't act this way in front of your daughter, because she'll likely imitate you in the future.
So, I just confirmed that you're ganging up on my daughter.
Mama, please, that's enough.
No, I won't let us go.
Hey, let's just all calm down. We should go home, all right? This is starting to get embarrassing.
All right, let go of me. It's best if we all go home now.
Sara, just ride with us, okay?
Why would I? After everything you've done to my daughter, you think I'll come with you? You really are something. Let's go.
How good is they shouldn't be doing this? Why are they fighting?
End of the show, end of the show. You can all go now.
Sir, these are the kids who will advance to the next round of auditions. Jessa Mariano and Kai Rodriguez.
Hi, kid. Wait a second. One kid is missing. Where's Rebecca Suarez?
Sir, I'm sorry. Unfortunately, we can't find her outside. But I already asked our staff to look for her.
No, let me find her myself. Excuse me, man. Sir, excuse me for a while.
How are you, kids?
Will you hurry up? You're not going back there, my goodness. This is what I'm telling you about. Come on, dear. Walk faster.
I wonder what's going on.
I can't believe her.
Miss, excuse me, did you happen to see a kid with a pink headband pass by here?
Oh, yeah. The one with those who were fighting earlier.
Oh, what, yes, did you say, a
right.
fight?
Some people were arguing upstairs earlier. The parents even came, and they're twins.
Wait, so where are they now?
Oh, they just went down.
You can still catch up on them.
All right, thank you very much.
Mm-hmm. Dear, walk faster. We're going straight home. Let's go. Get in.
Kara? Sara? Wait up! Hey, wait up!
Edward, where did you go? I've been waiting for you.
It's Sara, dude. I just saw her.
Your ex-girlfriend?
She already left, but she's with Becca, the kid who auditioned earlier. Can I look at her contact sheet?
It's just there.
With her address?
Yes, it's written there.
All right.
Okay, dude.
Oh, I think it's them. Andy, go open the door. Wait a second.
Okay, wait a minute.
Come
I'm coming.
Here,
hey, guys, come in.
Congratulations!
My dear.
Wipe along faces. What happened at the auditions?
Where is Kara?
We don't know where they are.
That means you went to fetch Becca. So what? Did they choose her?
I'm not in the mood to talk about it. Come on.
Sara, my dear. Wait.
What's the matter with her, Banjo?
Maybe you should ask her yourself.
What are you doing? Why are you packing your bags?
Why don't you ask Kara when she gets back, Mother?
But Sara, you're the one I'm asking. Answer my question now.
Mother, come on. I told you before that I came here because of you, okay? But I'm really fed up with Kara. If this is what she'll do to us, to me and my daughter, well, then we'll just leave this house, Mother.
Sir?
Hmm?
Do you know any Sara Suarez around here?
I'm sorry, sir. I'm not from around here.
All right, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Sir, are you looking for Sara Suarez?
Yes, ma'am. Do you know that person?
Yes, I know this person. What do you want from her?
She's my friend from way back. I just want to visit her, that's all.
Oh, too bad. You came too late, mister. They don't live here anymore.
They don't? They moved out?
No, not really. They were just renting at the compound. Actually, they barely come out of their home.
And why is that?
Well, I heard her father died recently, so she's with her family now.
Do you know where her family's address is?
No idea. But I know where she's currently working. It's at Club Felicidad. You can ask the tricycle drivers where it is, and they'll take you there.
All right, ma'am. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Anyway, ma'am, I know she's living with a little girl, am I right? Do you know her?
Oh, that's Becca. It's her daughter.
Well, do you know how old she is?
I'm guessing she's around 7 years old.
All right, thanks again, ma'am.
No problem.
You know, I was also a choreographer way back in our province.
Itoi, Kara's here now.
Oh, Kara, what took you so long? You could have just rode with Sara on your way home.
By the way, where is Sara?
Well, they're upstairs, talking to your mother.
Wait a minute. What on earth happened, Kara?
Hey.
Daddy?
Hannah, how are you? How's your audition? What's wrong?
It's Becca. She distracted me at the audition.
What? Is that true?
Seb, I don't know either. It was Alex who was with them at the audition.
I really think it's impossible, you know? Because Becky's definitely a good kid.
So what are you saying here? That Hannah's a liar?
No, but maybe you are.
Sorry to butt in, miss. But you have no right to accuse Becca. I've known the kid for so long, she can't possibly do that.
Excuse me, Mr. Bodyguard, but who the heck are you? This is for family members only, so mind your
own
business.
That's enough.
Oh my goodness. Now I understand why Sarah's fuming mad when she got here. I really pity your mom, Kara, because for sure Sarah's foaming at her mouth right this very moment.
Don't you worry, I'll talk to her personally. Excuse me.
But do you really have to go, huh? My dear, please sort this out with your sister.
Mother, we already talked at the audition. There's no need for it. It's already settled.
Sarah.
Your sister is here now.
Can we talk for a second?
Fix this right away. Becca, let's go.
So you're moving out?
Of course.
You're choosing to run away rather than settle this?
I'm not running away, Kara. I'm simply avoiding the problem. Who knows what your daughter might do to my daughter?
Sarah, please don't talk like that, okay? You didn't see what happened earlier. I'm sure that was just a misunderstanding.
You know what? It isn't. Let's just put it this way. I've been very protective over my daughter. Then Hannah will just bully her like that? I don't even let mosquitoes land on her skin, and there's your daughter hurting my child?
Well, I'm also very protective of Hannah. But Sarah, you did hurt my child.
You know what, Kara? The problem with your daughter is that she needs more discipline. You baby her too much, and that's why she's like that, a spoiled brat. She thinks she can do everything she wants.
Whatever. Sarah, you're being unfair. I thought we already agreed we're not going to meddle in your parenting affairs. Then why are you questioning me on how I raised my kid? You have no right to do that.
Oh, really? If you don't want me to talk this way, Kara, then discipline your adopted daughter. Go ahead. What are you waiting for?
Kara. Hey. Aren't you ashamed of yourselves? Instead of fixing the problem, you're making it worse.
I'm just proving a point. I can accept all the negative things she says to me, but not to my daughter. She doesn't deserve it.
Oh, really now? She doesn't deserve it? You think my daughter deserved to be hurt? You should reprimand that, Hannah.
I can't believe you. You're so immature.
Oh, no, I'm the one who's immature here. You know what? I really don't get it. Are you still in denial until now? She's not even your daughter, Kara. Did you give birth to her? Did you carry her in your womb for 9 months?
Yes, you're right, and I know that. But even if she isn't my daughter, I'm not going to let you talk to her like that. And I'm going to protect my daughter from the likes of you.
That's enough, you two. I told you a while ago to talk it out, right? That you should fix this mess and not to fight and get into an argument. Aren't you going to listen to me? I've been quiet for so long, you know. Whenever you get into a fight, I let your dad discipline you two. But your father's not here anymore. So give me the respect I deserve. I'm your mother, not some dummy.
Mom, I'm really sorry.
Better yet, cool your heads down a bit before talking to each other again.
You can go now.
Itoy?
Hmm.
Are Mama and Aunt Kara still fighting until now?
No, they're not. Well, I already talked to your grandmother. They settled things now. Your mama, dear, and her mommy, Kara, so everything's okay now. Oh, do you still hear anything? Any noise? That only means they've already made up, right?
Well, this is all your fault.
What?
Hey, little miss. Everything's okay now, so that's enough.
Banjo, Becca, let's go now.
Wait, where are we going, Mama?
We're going home now.
Hey! Wait a minute, you prickly witch! Why are you leaving? Your mom told me that you and Kara have already made up.
I'm sorry, Itoy, but I can't stay in this house any longer. Just tell Mother I'm sorry and I can't take it anymore.
Sarah, don't you feel sorry for your mother? Uncle Ishmael just died and you're just going to leave your mom just like that?
What's the matter? Everything was clear right from the start that I'm not going to stay here that long. It's a good thing that we leave this place this early to avoid disputes any further.
For goodness sake, Sarah, why do you even think of that, huh? Now that your father's gone, you should be thinking of a way on how to get along with each other as a family. For the sake of your mother, and not for your own good.
Banjo, can you take Becca outside?
All right.
And take our suitcases
Let's
with
go.
You.
For the meantime, Hannah, go to your mom upstairs.
I'm really sorry, Itoy, but I can't take this anymore. I've already decided, so don't insist.
My goodness, Sarah, you really are something. This is really getting crazy.
Sarah's right all along. Remember the time when she wasn't around? We're kind of peaceful here. So you know what, Sarah? I think it's better that you should leave because everything here is quiet without you.
You're really looking for trouble, huh?
Oh, come on. I'm just trying to help you explain so that you can fully decide to leave this place as soon as. Go ahead. You and your daughter should go now because you really have no place in here.
You're still as thick-faced as I remember you back then. What are you smoking? Do you really think you're part of this family?
Well, didn't you know? I have long replaced you in this family. Ever since you left, I'm the only one they can depend on, Sarah. And as for you, well, you got yourself pregnant, you left your family. You're a good-for-nothing daughter, right?
You little witch! Oh, you messed with the wrong girl! I am going to make you call what you just said!
Enough!
Do something!
That's enough! Alex! That's enough!
What now?
Why are you fighting?
You better shut her mouth! Teach her a lesson, do you hear me? Your dog keeps barking, you know. Don't be surprised if one day she'll bite you in the back. Let go of me! You stay out of this! Out of my way!
Alex, I'm so disappointed in you. Why do you have to involve yourself in this mess?
Well, Sarah started it all, Seb! She was already like that during the audition. She was blaming me why the kids were fighting.
What the heck really happened? Tell me the truth. Because even I have doubts about it. Why didn't you stop the kids from fighting? What on earth are you doing?
Believe me or not, Seb, but I was breaking them off, telling them to stop, forcing them to make up. It's not my fault if Beg is a mean kid and has an attitude. That's the reason why Hannah got fed up with her. You know what? If there's someone to be blamed here, it's not me. It's Sarah. The entire thing is all her fault because she didn't discipline her daughter enough.
Alex! It doesn't matter who started it first, okay? What I'm saying is you should talk it out with Sarah if you have a misunderstanding. And not make a big fuss about it.
Laura, I want you to know that Sarah and Becca already left the house.
What?
I don't know what happened, Laura. I thought you already talked to Sarah and Kara.
Well, yes. I thought they both understood what I was trying to say.
What are you going to do now, Laura? Are you just going to allow Sarah and Becca to leave this house?
You know how Sarah is. The moment she has decided, nothing, not anyone can stop her.
Does that mean we're not going to see Sarah and Becca anymore?
No, I'm not going to allow it. I'm not going to allow my family to be ruined like before. I'm not going to stop trying until I reconcile those two. That's a promise.
Kara, are you still thinking about what happened?
You know, I don't understand why we ended up this way, Seb. I just defended my daughter.
Kara, I understand. But is it really necessary to end this way? Kara, I thought we already talked about this before.
Seb, come on. Sarah hurt our daughter. And it's not like this is the first time Becca fought with Hannah. So I got fed up, you know?
Yes, you're right. This is not the first time. But Kara, that doesn't mean you two should keep pace with the kids, understand? Do you think everything will be okay if you two act just like them?
Seb, will you just stop? With what you're saying, it seems like it was wrong to defend our daughter.
But Kara, this isn't all about you. This is about you and Sarah and your relationship. You two are the adults here, but you let your emotions take over you.
You're right. I'm sorry. But I'm sorry. I will never apologize for protecting our daughter.
Kara, I don't want us to argue about this. I just don't want what happened before to happen again, okay? Both of you don't agree on many things. You two are different. You also have different views. But I hope we can try to get along and be happy for a change. For the sake of our family.
Hi, sir. Welcome to Club Felicidad. You know what? You came at the right time. We have an ongoing promo tonight. Buy one, and all the snacks are on the house.
Oh, no, thanks. Sorry. I didn't come here to drink. I'm looking for a girl who works here.
A girl?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm very sorry. I think you came to the wrong place. Our club is clean. We don't offer girls here.
Oh, you're mistaken. The girl I was looking for? Well, you see, someone told me she works here at your club, ma'am.
Oh, what's her name?
Sara. Sara Suarez. She has a daughter, Rebecca. Rebecca's her daughter's name.
Mama, don't be angry anymore. That's enough.
Yeah, she's right. It'll give you wrinkles, you know?
I'm sorry, dear, but, well, I couldn't hold it anymore.
I'm sorry you got into a fight because of me.
What are you talking about? Why are you saying sorry? They're the ones who hurt you.
It was partly my fault because I hurt Hannah. But I didn't mean to do it, you know?
She's small, but she's really something.
But it was Mama who said that I shouldn't get into a fight with her because we don't really live at that house.
Oh, ma'am, wait up. You seem stunned with what I said. Do you personally know them?
Yes. I know those two. But she's not here right now, and she hasn't shown up for work.
Is that so?
Sir, you know what? It would be best if you just go home because I still have a lot of things to do here, a lot of clients to entertain. All right, I'll go ahead.
Oh, ma'am, hold on. This is my business card, just in case they show up for work. Can you call me right away, please?
All right.
Thank you so much.
Dear, I know what I said. If it's just a small thing, you can let it go. But if it reaches to the point that they're already hurting you, you should have retaliated.
Mama, you're also a nice person, you know. And I don't want to see you get mad or something, so cheer up already.
You see, Sarah? You're also a nice person. So why don't you give us a smile?
Goodness.
Banja's right.
I'm really sorry, dear, but I just don't want to break my promise that no one's going to hurt you no matter who they are.
Who are you talking to a minute ago, madam? He's kind of handsome.
And he looks rich. There are things you're not telling us, huh? Who is he?
Who is he?
Is he a suitor?
Oh, look at you two. You two are amazing. No, what the heck? Come on, he's too young for me.
If not, then who is he?
The father of Becca.
What? Why did you let him leave?
She's right, madam. Becca's been looking for him, right?
Because the kid doesn't know anything at all. And besides, I know Sarah doesn't want to see him.
That only means Sarah really doesn't want to introduce Becca to her papa. What do you think are her reasons? He seems presentable.
And handsome.
You know what, guys? I don't understand either. But I'm pretty sure Sarah has her reasons why she keeps Becca away from her father and doesn't want them to meet at all.
Madam, do you plan to tell Sarah that he came looking for her?
Well, she needs to know. They need to meet and talk, so they can clear things up once and for all.
You're right about that, madam.
Mom, what brings you here?
I just brought you some groceries, and I wanted to congratulate you. Today was your go-see audition, am I right? So how was it?
Well, it was okay. Everything went out smoothly.
Oh, and why the long face then? You don't seem happy about
it. Sarah. She was there at the audition.
What? How on earth did Sarah find you? Did she get you into trouble?
Of course not, Mom. She was with a little girl today. The girl's cute and bubbly. I wanted to ask Sarah about the little girl she's with.
She's not your daughter, Edward.
Mom, all I said is that I saw Sarah, but we never got the chance to talk. Why did you react that way, Mom? And you immediately told me, that kid isn't my daughter. Mom, I just want to talk to Sarah. Because I want to get the kid for the audition.
No, you see, I just thought maybe you were thinking what I was thinking. That's why I said what I said.
Mom, it's not it. Please, tell me the truth. Did you know Sarah has a kid already?
What? How can I possibly know that, son? Oops, you know, I forgot something. I just remembered. I have an appointment at the spa. I'll go ahead, okay?
Mom.
Doesn't look like...
All right, okay.
Hey, wait a second.
Hi, Sarah.
Becca, my pretty baby Becca.
Hello, Madam Cynthia.
Sarah, Banjo, what took you so long?
What audition did you go to? A Wake of the Dead? Look at the time already.
Hey, yes, it's
stop kidding
late.
Around. Cynthia, we're really sorry. Well, something just happened.
What on earth happened? Did you just leave your family?
You're right about that, madam.
But what happened?
You know what, madam? It's a long story. Can we save it for next time? I don't want to have to keep on explaining things.
Let me be the one to explain, Mama.
Look at her. Good thing Becca's here. Come on, my dear. Explain. Tell us what happened.
Hannah and I fought with each other during the audition. Then Mom and Aunt Kara got mad. So? They argued and fought.
I'm sorry about what happened earlier.
I'm glad you realized that, dear. I just hope that when they get home, Sarah will realize that too.
I know, I got carried away by my emotions, Mother. But Sarah's really getting out of hand. She said a lot of nasty things to Hannah. I just defended my daughter against her.
I understand why you both acted that way, because you and your sister are both mothers now. But you know, my dear, that doesn't mean that you forget to humble yourselves and respect each other as a person. You know, Kara, I'm really happy that you both turned out to be great mothers, you and Sarah. But you see, I don't want that to be the cause of another dispute between you and Sarah. Do you understand what I'm saying?
I'm really sorry. We didn't mean to hurt you because of that, Mother. I mean, you yourself said that you would fight for us until the end. And that's what Sarah and I were trying to do here.
Why did you involve yourself in the kids' fight?
Madam, it isn't the kids' fight, you know. That little girl is the one who hurt my daughter. And here's the proof of that.
Ouch, it hurts, Mama.
Sarah, be careful. Sorry, my dear. Easy.
Oh, shh. All right, let's get you inside. Let's treat that wound.
Take care of it.
Sure.
Oh, my poor baby. Okay, see you later, Becca. So, Sarah, what did your mom say about you leaving the house?
Nothing, because she doesn't know yet. All she wants is for Kara and I to make up, so there. I ran away from her again.
Oh, my, are you kidding me, Sarah? Why would you do that?
Madam, if you only knew how I felt. I cannot stand being with Kara, especially that goblin of a daughter of hers.
That's harsh. A little goblin?
Mom, I know you. You're hiding something from me. Can you just tell me the truth? How on earth did you know that Sarah has a kid?
I told you, I don't know, son. Well, I just assumed.
Mom, for once, please. I'm begging you to tell me. Tell me the truth. Did you see Sarah in Japan?
Yes, I saw her back then.
Mom, why did you hide it from me? Why did you lie to me?
I'm just protecting you, that's all. She was pregnant at that time. She was looking for you. She said you were the father of her child. Listen, you can't be together, Edward.
So you sent her away, is that it? What the heck is your problem with Sarah? Why do you hate her so much?
Because she doesn't suit you. When I had you, Edward, I swallowed every nasty thing people said to me. Because I was the mistress of your father. I've done everything I can. I threw my shame away just to give you a bright future. And you're just gonna end up with a girl like her? No way, son! I'm not gonna allow you to waste everything I've worked for all these years, you hear me?
But Mom, did it ever cross your mind? What if that kid was mine? Come on, you tell me!
The kid isn't yours! Sarah was just a desperate woman!
Well, you could have checked if it was true before telling me that to my face right now! What if I got Sarah pregnant?
You've already broken up with her!
Something happened to us here in the Philippines before going back to Japan!
Too bad, Sarah. You wasted a great opportunity. I had plans to make you a princess. But I'm not going to let you get away with the humiliation and the rejection you brought upon me. No one has ever done that to me without suffering the consequences. I'm going to make sure you're going to come to me begging. Begging me to help you if my plan works out and succeeds.
Aunt Alex?
Hey, what's the matter?
Do you think Mommy and Aunt Sarah are still mad at each other? You know, Aunt Sarah might get mad at me again.
Well, you saw them leave, right? What's the matter? Is there a problem, Hannah?
Thank you for defending and being on my side, but you never told them the truth.
If I hadn't done that, dear, you'll get yourself in trouble with your mom. You know, I do understand why you're like that, okay? Because you know, and I know, what really happened earlier. You stole Becca's audition piece, am I right? You're the first to hurt her, and you're the first to push her, right?
Aunt.
Don't worry, my dear. They will never know what truly happened.
But what if they find out, Aunt Alex?
They will never find that out if you're not going to change your story, okay? Like I said, dear Hannah, I'm on your side, remember? So I will always defend you. I'm not going to tell them either that you were the one who hurt Becca. That's our little secret, okay? Because We are allies, just you and me and no one else. Deal?
It's a deal, Aunt.
Very good. Come on, give me a smile. There. You shouldn't frown, my dear. Always put on a smile. Everything will be all right.
Mommy?
Yes, dear?
What are you doing at this hour?
I'm just finishing some work.
Are you still mad at me, Mommy?
And why do you ask, dear?
Because Aunt Sarah and Becca left the house already.
Hannah, don't think about it too much. It's their decision to leave the house.
Are you still sad because they left already?
Yes, of course, Mommy's very sad, but I'm more concerned about you, Hannah. And I'm not going to let anyone hurt you, do you understand? Especially here inside my house. And always remember that you're my daughter. I'll always fight for you.
Madam, here's your juice.
Thank you.
Hey, why do you seem unhappy that you're here now? Let me guess, you don't want to be with us anymore? You don't want to come back here anymore?
Come on, I'm just sad, that's all. I just don't want to see my mom and Aunt Kara fighting. It's all my fault.
Is it really true? Are you sure you initiated the fight with your cousin? Because I don't believe you're capable of doing that.
Well, I wish I never retaliated so Hannah won't get hurt. Then Mom and Aunt Kara wouldn't have fought and argued, and we wouldn't have had to leave the house.
You know what, Becca? You're just defending yourself. Come on now. If you allow others to push you around, Hannah will never stop bullying you. You should also let her know that you're also hurt and you can feel the pain. And I'm pretty sure if your mama talks to you, she will also tell you this. You didn't mean to hurt her, right?
But you see, Aunt Kara's mad at me.
Oh, she should try to understand the situation. And if she truly knows you, well, she should know that you're definitely a nice kid. Anyway, you should forget about it, madam. You're already here. No one's going to hurt you in your turf.
Based on my mom's reaction earlier, I already knew why Sarah went to Japan at that time. She was pregnant with our child. That was 7 years ago, bro. 7 years. I had no idea that I had a daughter with her. I wish I was there to help Sarah. I wish I was there to take care of the child, right?
Dude, it's not too late. You can still help. Now you know the situation, you still have a chance to make things right. You should think about that, Edward. Don't get stuck in the past. You should be concerned with how you can be a good father to your child. Not wallowing in self-pity.
Come on, you don't have to worry about me. I'm okay now. I felt a sudden change, maybe because I already let all my grudge and frustrations out. There's no heaviness in my heart. You know, I'm more excited to go home to our apartment because living at Kara's house, my goodness, I felt suffocated. I couldn't breathe.
Sarah, I have something to tell you.
What is it?
I didn't tell you earlier because you were ranting. Well, Edward, he dropped by earlier.
What? Edward passed by earlier? How did he find out that I worked here?
Well, I don't know that, Sarah, but he was looking for you. Oh, by the way, he left something for me to give you. Sarah, it seems like he wanted to talk to you.
We have nothing to talk about, madam.